First and foremost, my gratitude to PIDS, a very, very respected institution, and of course to its president, Dr. Yanto, who many of us are working. I'm sorry, Chuck, but I was just sent two papers, but Chuck and I have talked, and I'm supposed to wrap up priority to the three, but let's begin by saying that, among other things, Chuck yourself an expert, and we talk about the importance of accountabilities, answerabilities, and that will be a theme, if you may, that I will discuss in this quick presentation, reacting to the paper of Ron, and of course to Dr. Corpus. First and foremost, over the past so many years, we've had this whole discussion, national-local relations. And this is really within the context of our continued attempt to bring about devolution. So I guess my point here is that when we talk about federalism, it should not be divorced from or separated from our discussion of devolution. And in one sense, I think Paul mentioned this earlier, it's really up to us to define the discourse. I agree with you, let's look at all models, you know, Chad and many of us have been to different countries, look at devolution, but at the end of the day, we have to define our own model of the federalism, which I think should be closely linked to our discussion of federalism. Why? To devolution. Why? Because we've been talking devolution for the past 25 years. We have learned a lot, many good lessons, and areas to work on. And this includes, among others, national local relations, that's very much federal. Part of the federal discourse, delineation functions, responsibilities, what is shared, what is joint, what is exclusive, etc. Financial decentralization, Chad has talked about a million times. I mean, I've known you perhaps for the past 20 years, and we've talked about this. And we've talked about the internal revenue allotment, we've talked about this formula, population, land area, and how not to do it, and we continue to do it, you know. And I tell my friends from Indonesia, you guys are lucky. You learn from our mistakes, one of which is our era formula. Population land area equals sharing. Let's not include land area. But the point there is that this whole discussion of sharing of resources, financial and otherwise, has already been around. When we talk federalism, it's essentially taking off from the same platform. And the two others, which I think runs and Art's discussion, inter-local cooperation, that I think is the point of Dr. Corpus about, you know, area, okay? Spatial, some say spatial. But you know, that is so true because hindi to bago. What was the first decree Marcos signed? In IRP, Integrated Organization Plan. But it was not his because it was pending in Congress since 1969. It was really a bill that was Integrated Organizational Plan, and part of that, core of that was the division of the country into administrative regions. The discussion was there, we built on that in the IRP, we created our 11 regions, and today these are now administrative regions. Question, can this be the take-off points of our states? Certainly. Our point, don't we already have this whole mindset that these are regions? We have this whole mindset of dividing them according to geography, dividing them according to, you are the planners, the people especially, linguistic, dividing them according to other factors. It was already there. Federalism will learn, build upon that. The third one, bossism and dynastism. This is really Ron's expertise. I like your presentation so much, but hey, he talked about Abra, my province, number one province of the country, alphabetically, okay. After having said that, alam mo Ron, what you forgot to point out, maganda po yun, kasi I'm from Abra. My parents really are. I'm from Baguio, really. It's also the highest in the city. Anyway, in Abra, you forgot to mention one thing, pare. When we talk about bossism, when we talk about devolving authority, we also talk about accountabilities. We talk about people participation. And in Abra, with the devolution, we had a very strong group called CCAGG, Concerned Citizens of Abra for Good Governance, that actually encouraged citizen participation and went up there to try to check the whole point of Chad and Ron earlier, accountability. Yes, perhaps we're not yet there, but the point is, in terms of our mindsets, will it strengthen authorities? Yes, but more importantly, let's look at the other side. Will it strengthen accountabilities? Instead of saying, tama na may mga bosses, instead of saying, tama na yung mga dynasties, they've been there ever since we were born, you know, they're there. But can we encourage more citizen participation? And it works. We've seen that in our many programs. Of course, I will not romanticize it. Gilbert always warns me against anecdotal, etc. But anecdotal or not, there are good examples that can be replicated. So this whole discussion of federalism should be seen not specific historical moment, but it is evolutionary. Evolutionary. Some, at one in a forum I was with recently, they said, sa Belgium, 20 years, 30 years, pa mag-federalism. Tayo, kung gagawa tayo ng time, and I would say, if we talk about when did we started federalism, if we define it within the concept of context of the evolution, and that has started even during the Barrio Charter Act, etc., the Batas Pambansa 337, during the local government code. So matagal na po, within the context of democratization, participation. So that will be how I put it. So siguro around that one point, let's talk about the CCAGG, Concerned Citizens of Abroad for Good Governance. So that's a good example. And there are many examples all over, which we have, by the way, documented in this small but quite respectable program called Galing Po Program, which we started some time back. And lastly, and finally, we talk about capacities. Ron, talk about guns, goods, go. Okay. You know, Mario, you might want to add glitter. We added that because, hey, these are really the traditional ways to become a local official, but if you are a celebrity, buhay ka na. So maybe it's a 4G. Number two, challenges of dynasty, continued elite capture. It is really a real thing. I've attended so many fora on this by all kinds of groups, academic and otherwise, and there are those who say, you know, federalism is the answer. I tell, relax lang, you know, take it easy, because you're setting the people up for frustration. Let's take a hard look at ourselves and say, we need data, we need information, precisely what Dr. Corcus and Dr. Mendoza have been doing. These are the kinds of things that we do, and really, Pitch is doing such an excellent job in providing the hard data that we talk, evidence, as my boss, Gilbert Yanto, always tells me, because at one point he was my team leader in a program on this. Evidence-based, okay. Number two, kapapagalitan naman niyan. Number two, political dynasties, by the way, they've been there ever since. I am from the north, no? And we all know the Crisologos, the Simpsons, up north, and they're there. The point is, how do we encourage, instead of working on the supply side, let's work on the demand side, which is provided for in the local government code, which should be provided for in the federal structure. Emphasize accountability, as Dr. Manasa mentioned. And he looked at 3 years, Bangsa, or Northern Luzon, etc. And we've had several forums on this, and we're very happy, of course, and grateful that this is really part of the continued effort to bring about more hard-boiled evidence. Okay. Finally, it locates it within the context of devolution. I know, Ron, you've been part of this group on ADB. This is what I was saying earlier with Gilbert. It was 10 years ago. We also did a study on devolution, and it's mixed results. But what do you expect? You don't expect something perfect. But the point is, we are moving in that direction. I think so. Okay. Well, of course, Dr. Corcus mentioned about state boundaries matter, and they do matter. Question, how do we carve out? You know what, let's build on the integrated reorganization plan. Let's build on the administrative regions, which we already have. Let's build on the RDC. My thesis was on the RDC Regional Development Council a long, long time ago. But you know, the whole idea, RDC, talking lang yan. Come on, you don't expect me to be making decisions at this point. We should emphasize that it is evolutionary. We don't have it overnight. And this is really part of this whole continuing structure to build upon, seek appropriate political administrative structures, that we are doing precisely what we are doing today. Okay, and his paper suggests that it should be efficiency oriented, how to identify boundaries. Sabi na, let's look on the IRP nandiyan po yan. And more, of course, you have several permutations, where there's 3 states, 16 states, etc., etc. Pero boundaries do matter. So finally, let me talk about, so remember the local government code, sa inyo kapangyarihan, sa inyo rin ang pananagutan. Can we look at the other side? I'm not romanticizing it, but I think let's look at that, because that is what governance is all about. Accountabilities, answerabilities, etc. People participation. It sounds romantic, but true. And perhaps, I don't know, I said, at one point, we can even have a next study that would include, instead of looking now at all of the bosses, perhaps we can look at some of our winners, good and best practices. I must say, so inspiring practices that have won this Galing Po Awards. Of course, I'm not romanticizing it, but the point is, it can be done, it has been done, we have seen it happen. Okay, if you have bosses, you have also unbosses, you have also uncertainties. Without, of course, romanticizing it. Well, I've already mentioned this about the whole discourse, it's really on national, local, and the next one is I would like to point out, really, is I already talked about the integrated reorganization plan. Let's build on that. Dr. Corcus talked about the debates on PCR, you talked about They need to bring about physical structure. How do you do this? Our native people are our artists, our physical features, geographic, natural boundaries, river basin. I mean, come on, we've all heard about the Bicol River Basin Development Program that many of us have worked on. It's so because we all know that political administrative boundaries are artificial. Let's work on the river basin, let's work on watershed, let's work on marine, etc. Nandiyan po yan, and that will serve as the basis for carving out cordilleras where we're from. You can have now this linguistic and ethnic delineation. Dr. Miller Mando has, as a matter of fact, organized a very, very successful forum where we had all the Cordilleran people there. And they talk about linguistic divide. They talk about things that are not even in the law because we have our own basic laws there. Okay. So, in the debates on IRP, what should be the capital? Should Baguio, San Fernando, Legazpi, Naga? Napag-usapan din, and we continue revisiting these factors. And like I said, the IRC. This is something that I've been doing since 19, a long time ago. When we talk about decentralization, it's really a continuum. It's really just a construct that as you move to the right, it's really transferring more and more powers within the context of autonomy. We had a side discussion earlier about Polotilia and chat, but it's really transferring powers within the context of the concentration, ito administrative, devolution, nilagay ko dito autonomy kasi kanina umaga we were talking about the Indonesian example, autonomy or merdeka. And ito, somebody asked earlier this morning, a question this morning, what if independence? Ang sabi pa natin Chief Justice Puno, you know, let's go all the way here, but let's put in the constitution what they call a lucky provision na hindi maaaring lumiwalag. But let's not kid ourselves, it is entirely possible. Put it in the constitution, hindi maaaring lumiwalag. Yun yung tawag na lucky provision. But as you go further to the right, you're sending powers at the local level, which matter. Point, when you talk about federalism, let us define the discourse. Point, let us relate it to strengthening local governments. And the point is, let's call it federalism. Paul said earlier, call it what you may. And I totally agree with him. And for the longest time, I'm saying this is our variation of federalism. If focus natin ito, kasi doable po ito, bakit? Sapagkat meron na tayo over 25 years and more experience. Pag dyan natin pinasok po, people will be quite familiar with this. And Mahar asked earlier, if you were to do a survey, do you agree or agree with federalism? What I would do, Mahar, would be, instead of saying, do you agree, ang gagawin mo, dun sa survey mo, I would say, you know, how was your life before or after devolution? Is it better now or worse? And that's a very, very hard question. I don't know, when we relate to devolution, hindi ko alam. Pero kung magtatanong ka doon, kasi kung i-frame mo within devolution, maaaring yun, it might be proxy, whatever, but it's something that we can look at. Okay, so I'm almost there. So the next steps, let's build on gains. Call it, whether Paul just added this today, obviously. Call it what you mean. And yes, federalism is the next logical step. Sa tingin ko lang po. Kung if, so in one sense, we define the discourse. To Professor Monsoto said earlier, are you for federalism? Yes, if you ask me, yes, I'm for federalism. If it will strengthen our subnational governments, which at the end of the day is what where power should lie. After all, that's what Demoskratos is all about. Ito, maganda po ito, napag-itin po ni Dr. Corpus, inter-local cooperation. We have many examples of inter-local cooperation. 2 minutes. Inter-local cooperation, wherein, among others, they cooperate because of solid waste management, they cooperate to protect a watershed, and I think that is within the context now of carving out what are the appropriate states within a federal framework. So we all know, of course, the first two political amalgamations, if you may, because it's in the local government code, inter-local cooperation was the Island Garden City of Samar and of course Sorsogon Bacon. But they can cooperate on their own, mag-MOU sila po within the context. And I know Dr. Meyer and his team have always been advocating inter-local cooperation. And this is really now an opportunity for massive local governance reform. I'll end by saying, you know, we talk about capacity building. And yes, that is something that we should be doing within the context of the continued debate on federalism. And I'll end with this, that at one point, since I have come from the... I won't end with that anyway. This one. We already have hubs. No? At one point over the past so many months, just going around, work with the local universities, work with the local schools, and they will be the ones to really come up with the hard data, not here in Manila, if you mean. No? We have hubs in Ilocos, all the way to Cordilleras, okay, and we can serve the local schools, and we can tap them. Somebody talked earlier about having mini PIDs, big PIDs, why don't you go and develop their capacities? That would be entirely possible, because they can be the repository of information. So I guess with that, I'd like to thank you for this opportunity, Dr. Yanto and PIDs, and you know, let's build on the hardware gains as far as revolutions, as far as federalism is concerned, and related to this continuing this discussion on devolution. Maraming salamat po. Mabuhay.